I keep people safe, I should say, from the deleterious effects of toxic and harmful and reactive chemicals. With the Oakland Fire Department, I have to respond to hazardous material spills all over within our jurisdiction. And one of the things as chemists, we have a position called the Technical Reference Specialist, and we have to identify unknown solids and liquids in the field, and gases basically, using basic chemistry qualitative analysis. As a chemist with Haztech Systems, I teach wet chemistry qualitative analysis to lay people. That includes the Army, the National Guard, the U.S. Coast Guard Strike Team, a lot of firefighters, environmental health departments. And I teach them how to use this wet chemistry qualitative analysis kit and also do the research and development for it so that it gets easier to use all the time. I think the key is having a good communication skill and knowing their subset of words that they would use to describe a particular reaction. You think of the word dissolve, perhaps. I find that there's a huge percentage of lay people that consider dissolve to be something that could be finely suspended. And they don't really understand that when something dissolves, it disappears. So you have to break down what a chemist would think of as very, very basic and not be condescending to them when we're teaching them this sort of thing. What's illegally dumped and abandoned out there oftentimes is so complex that the machines, the spectroscopic methods, can't come up with a good answer. No match found, or just not in the library. So picking apart a mixed bag of unknown materials, oftentimes the best tool out there still to this day is using wet chemistry qualitative analysis techniques.